Today on The Daily Dose, Thomas Jefferson. After graduating from the College of William and Mary in 1762, Thomas Jefferson studied law under Virginia attorney George Wythe before opening his own practice in 1767. Well respected from an early age, from 1769 to 1775, Jefferson became a member of the Virginia House of Burgesses, later renamed the Virginia House of Delegates after independence from Great Britain. Inheriting land near Charlottesville, Virginia, Jefferson's keen interest in architecture and gardening led to the construction of his beloved Monticello, or Little Mountain in the Italian, where he and his young wife Martha gave birth to 6 children before Martha's untimely death at the tender age of 33. While only 2 of their children would survive into adulthood, Jefferson was so devastated by the loss of his beloved wife that he would never marry again. As war broke out with Great Britain, in 1775, Jefferson was selected as a delegate to the Second Continental Congress, where he penned the first draft of the Declaration of Independence at 33 years of age, resigning the following year when he was re-elected to the Virginia House of Delegates. From 1779 to 1781, Jefferson served as governor of Virginia before landing his second stint in Congress from 1783 to 1784. A year later, Jefferson succeeded Benjamin Franklin as U.S. Minister to France, and upon his return to the States in 1789, President George Washington appointed him as the nation's first Secretary of State, where he frequently bucked heads with Secretary of the Treasury and staunch big government Federalist Alexander Hamilton over foreign affairs, interpretations of the Constitution, and the size and authority of the federal government. Hamilton's insistence on a strong federal government would lead Jefferson to co-found the Democratic-Republican Party, which was an ideological precursor of today's Republican Party. In the presidential election of 1796, Jefferson defeated John Adams for the office of vice president, later running a second time against Adams for president during the election of 1800, which proved to be a bitter fight between the Federalists and the Democratic Republicans, just a few short years after both political sides had been so united in their revolutionary calls for independence. The crowning achievement of Jefferson's first term was his successful orchestration of the Louisiana Purchase from France, followed by Lewis and Clark's expedition into the newly purchased lands, an 8,000-mile journey which took them to the Pacific Ocean and back. Handily re-elected in 1804, Jefferson's second-term focus was to steer the United States safely away from involvement in the Napoleonic Wars of 1803 to 1815, which at one point or another dragged much of Europe into the conflict. After turning down a third term as president, Jefferson returned home to his beloved Monticello, where he continued to pursue his interest in architecture, music, reading, and gardening, at the same time helping to found the University of Virginia, which opened its doors for its first student body in 1825. After his death on July 4, 1826, 50 years to the day after he signed the Declaration of Independence, his surviving estate was heavily mired in debt due to a lifetime of extravagant spending, which in turn required that his slaves be sold at auction alongside his land holdings, art, and furnishings, forever cementing Thomas Jefferson into the early history of a newly formed nation. And there you have it, the life and works of Thomas Jefferson, today on The Daily Dose. If you want early access to Daily Dose documentaries before they're made publicly available, consider supporting us on Patreon so that you too could feed the filmmakers who feed your brain.